doing Phantom on Broadway when the film came out. And we were fortunate to be invited to one of the launches, to the New York premiere. And it was really awesome to be sitting there in the theater watching the film come to life and the stars of the film in the room with us. And I got to see Emmy Rossum, and she's a lovely actress and so beautiful, and got to tell her what a wonderful job she did. And there were things about the film that I really loved. I think they explained certain things that we've gotten questions for years about who's the guy in the wheelchair at the beginning of the show. And they really showed the Madame Giry and Raoul and relationships. They explained certain things in ways that were, I thought, very intelligent. And the beauty of the cinematography was wonderful. And there were things that a lot of us preferred in the stage version. You know, of course, there's nothing like seeing a show on stage.
Well, I think that, you know, the trade-off that seems to be the common trade-off in any, you know, here's a film, here's a Broadway production. You can talk about it with Phantom. You can talk about it with the Les Mis film. And these are, you know, we're talking about recent movie musicals. The number one thing that I want to say, which I say about superhero films too, at the end of the day, I'm just so glad they're getting made, you know, because there was such a long time when these things that we love, music for me, musicals for me, superheroes, weren't getting their due in this medium that we all love so much. So to see them happen at all is a celebration, you know. Then having said that, you then look at it and say, well, I wish they'd do this better, I wish they'd do that better. The common thread seems to be that people tend to agree that the singing is what suffers in movie musicals by and large, that in Phantom the singing wasn't what people are going to experience when they see it on a stage. The same was said by many, many people about Les Mis, that, you know, it was beautiful physical rendering of it, but the singing, unfortunately, isn't what we've come to expect from seeing it on stage. And so somebody's got a different criteria, you know, where the films are being made in this way, where the music isn't getting what I believe is the high level of regard that it gets when it's performed on a Broadway stage. But by the same token, that gives you all the more reason to go and have that experience, you know. We were talking about, earlier we were talking about Frozen and about Idina Menzel singing, you know, the role that she sings in Frozen. You know, that's a voice for the ages. It's an amazing, amazing voice. And it's wonderful to see it imprinted in film, which, you know, is going to survive the length of our society, and that kind of thing is there. And I would hope that, you know, knowing that a great voice can inspire and elevate that medium as well, will continue to make film producers say, yeah, we'd also like to have this sound really great. Because bringing it back to Broadway, one of the things I think everybody loves the most about going to a Broadway show is hearing a phenomenal, you know, theater voice. And there's something about it that literally changes you when you sit there and listen to it. You just say, wow, that is so inspiring in a way that I could not have anticipated. That to me is the element that has been missing, that was missing in the Phantom film. But there was a lot that was there. And the beauty of film as a medium, as we've come to see over generations, there will be another Phantom of the Opera film. It may not be in our lifetime, but it will happen. And so here's a blueprint that someone's going to look at and say, you know, I would like to remake this. You know, Spielberg is going to remake West Side Story now. You know, I'm all for that. I think it's magnificent. These great pieces of art should be revisited, should be looked at through different lenses, with different voices, with different talents. So I just celebrate that they're getting made.